Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video, we were able to write our mutations, queries and subscription. Now in this video, we are going to have a look on to the documentation and we will integrate these queries and mutation subscription with our app component. Okay. So I have already shown you all these things like how to set up a transport. We are using subscription transport WebSocket library. And if you remember, we created a WebSocket link, we created a HTTP link, WebSocket link and HTTP link, and then we create a split link, right? And this link we are passing in the Apollo client, right? These are the same steps which we have already performed. Now, I mean, our WebSocket server is not like requires authentication and all these things, but yeah, if you want to secure it with some token, you can achieve it like this. Now, there are two things. How we can subscribe to the subscription at the client end side means like a comment is added or post has been created, then if we are subscribing, we should automatically receive the payload. There are two things. Either you subscribe to the updates for a query, or you can use here the use subscription. You can see here I'm subscribing the comment subscription and the variable is the post ID because I'm subscribing to this for this particular post ID. And another thing is you can do it with the query also. What that means is from one place we are adding a post and GraphQL server will say, okay, the new post has been added. It will publish that from the subscription and we can listen those kind of subscriptions using use query only. Okay, little interesting. Let's see how we are doing here. So let's say we have the comments where you are actually adding a comment, deleting comment and all these things. Okay, if you see this simple example, comment subscription, either we create a explicit subscription and use subscription, or we can do it with a use query also. In the use query, you can say subscribe to more. That means whenever there is a new data, you will be able to receive that data in the subscribe to more, right? Here we are looking for comment subscription. Let's say on one page you are showing the list of the post, on another page you are actually adding the new post, and whenever the new post is added in the list post query, you automatically wants to receive the new updates coming from the server, right? So those things we can combine with the use query only instead of using use subscription in that particular case. You add the new entry in the form, automatically it will go to the GraphQL server using mutation. It will update the data, update the state, and it will also publish a subscription. I mean, it will publish the event. And on the front end side, we just need to subscribe more. In the use query hook, subscribe to more will be listening to all the updates coming for this particular query. Because the query hasn't changed, but the data for this query has changed. The query is fetch the list of the post. The initially there were 10 posts I'm able to fetch. Now the 11th post has been created by user and that mutation is throwing one event. That is a subscription and we are already subscribing to the subscribe to more. Then we can automatically receive the 11th record on the post. Okay. This is interesting. I was using use subscribe, then I came to know, okay, you can also do something like this. So we can implement it like this. Let's see this in the example, how we are doing it. So we'll move to our code. Here we have written all the subscription, queries, and mutation. And we are exporting it here. Let's go to our app component. Now we'll write our core things. Let's say you have two different forms. Two different text fields, let's say the title for the post and body for the post. We are writing a functional component. This component, you can say the container component. Okay, and we have two fields, so we can use use state here, title and set title. And we can say use state, title is empty. And here also we can have another state, which is body. And we can say set body right? There are two form fields in the whole application. Now we can use some hooks to list to fetch all the data. Use effect. Okay, you might already know how to write use effect hook. This is the dependency array we have, and what it is returning, nothing. Okay, we'll decide what we wanted to return from here. Now this is a simple use effect, and there will be a on click event in which we will be loading the data. Before that, we have other things to set up, like we want to use query. So const, all the things which you wanted to put, and we can use query. And in the use query, we need to pass the query name. Okay, so all those things we can import from GraphQL, the query mutation and subscription, and we are talking about the post query. So this particular query is not, we are not passing any argument, but there may be a query which requires the arguments to be passed. Like I will not use it, just for example, like how to pass the variable for the query. Post query, string, let's say, not a good name. Here what we are doing is, in this we can simply put a query name. Okay, let's say this is a search query. You can create alias, and this is taking an argument. The argument is, let's say, text, and this text is type of string, and that is an optional. You may or may not pass. And then in the posts, you can pass this. I think we are passing it as a query, and query will hold the text value. Right? This is pretty much simple. This is how you can pass the variable. Now, while using it, let's say I'm using this particular query. Okay, I will also export this, and I will import this in the app.js. And I wanted to use this particular query. Now, while using it, we need to pass the variables, right? So variables is an object. And inside variable, I can say the text is hello. So if you see this query, the dynamic argument is text, which is of type string, and the same text value will be published here. Right, this is how you can use this use query, and you can also pass dynamically the arguments. Currently we are not passing any arguments, so we are not using it. We are using the simple post query, which is giving us the list of posts, and this post query will return us few things. I mean, the loading state, we have seen it is returning few arguments: loading, error if there is error, otherwise it will return data. These are the basic arguments it will return whenever we are hitting a use query. We can see if the data is there, if it is loading, if it is throwing error. So in our JSX, we can play with these different state. Like if there is a loading, that means data haven't come. So we can simply write our JSX for this particular example. Let's say what we are returning here is a simple JSX, and we are using these columns and all. Extra small is 6. Okay, now what we are doing here, we can check the state, because if it is loading, these are the smart state, you can say. If it is loading, we can show something like loading or something like this. So we can simply say it is loading. And if you have received an error, right? So first is the loading. If it is loading, otherwise it has another state, and here in the another state we will check if it is error, right? Same again, ternary operator. If it is error, otherwise we got the data, right? So here I can say I mean, you can play with this error occurred or something if it is an error. Otherwise, we really got the data. So data will be data.posts. Sorry. I think a lot of code we have written here. Let's split this. So we have data.posts. And obviously now we have the posts information here. What we can do is we can pass it to the child component. That will take care of rendering this. So we can create a post component. The data we are passing is a post. And we are also passing key, which is an ID. That's it, right? So this is just a one part of the whole application where we are saying that we are just triggering the use query. Similarly, we can also do the use mutation. Like this is the another thing we are doing, right? The listing of the post, and once the form is filled, we are actually triggering the mutation that will send this request to the GraphQL mutation and will say, okay, the new form, new record you have to create, use mutation, and here we'll pass the mutation query, create post mutation, since you are creating a post. And here we are not maintaining all these state, we can say add post. Now this add post can be triggered because it's not like on the page load we want to trigger the mutation, we also need to have a data for this. So we can call add post once the form is being submitted. So we are going to write a simple form, and let's say we are writing a method here only, const handle submit of that HTML form which we are going to write. Event.driven default, whenever you are submitting a form, to stop the propagation. And you can also do the event.stop propagation. Now if you have validated the form, you have all the data, then you simply call add post. And here if you see this mutation, it is taking argument, right? It is taking all the arguments which we need to pass. So we need to pass the variables, right? So variables, and inside variables we are passing title. Let's say I'm hard coding this for now. Test body, then we have published, which is true. Author ID is the last argument, and all are required. That means all needs to be there, otherwise your mutation will not work. Now we just triggered this. Once this is done, you can reset the form, set title, set body, empty. This is again empty, right? And we can just trigger this whenever there is a change. So whenever form is valid, we just click onto the button, handle submit, we will submit this form, right? So this is the basic integration we are doing. We are doing a query, we are doing a mutation. Now in the next video, we will take a look onto the important aspect. Let's say when you are submitting a form, how the form submit is happening and how we can capture the change happening in the posts using this query only. So as we have seen, there is another argument, subscribe for more. Subscribe to more. This is the argument which we can pass, and we can actually, this will get triggered whenever there is a new post added in the system. Right, and we can use this use effect which we have created. Let's say I am doing this, all this stuff here, and we can look for the subscribe to more in the dependencies. Okay, and here we can call this method. This method takes an object. And here we are doing all the different things which you want, like what all operations we wanted to perform, that we will do here. So whatever, whenever you are hitting the mutations, new records will come. We will merge the record with the existing records which we have in the system. Let's see this in the next video.